You're live in 2, 3. Now.
All right. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning, Atlanta. Good morning, Southeast. Good morning, Northeast. Good morning, wherever you are. Thank you for being here on the last day of 2022, at least in our calendar year, which, you know, means something to us. Saurel, I got two terrible questions for you.
I thought you were going to use the word joke, Gio, because that's a no-no in your camp. You don't announce a joke by saying, I got a good joke.
I got two terrible ones. What do cows say on New Year?
Happy Moo Year.
And what do ghosts say on New Year?
You're bad.
No, happy Boo Year.
Play that video, man.
I told you that was it.
From here, guys.
It's terrible. They're bad.
Congratulations, Gio. You have scraped the bottom of the barrel. I love it. I love it. Good morning. Good morning, on and all. Giovanni and I are excited to be with you on the 30th of December to lead a conversation anchored in this question: what you can't put behind you runs your business. And you may discover that what you can't put behind you runs a lot of other things in your life. So, but before we dive into that conversation, I am excited to ask a few questions. Good morning, Tara. It's always great to see you here. Tell me, what time is it and what are you grateful for?
Let's see, what time is it? The time is right now, the only time that truly matters. And I have to say, I am grateful to be healthy right now.
Thank you, Tara, and good morning to you. Look who's here. Ronald is here, and he's not in the office. Ronald, where are you? And
I am right here, right now, in my office where I'm supposed to be, at the Daily Huddle now.
And who are you going to hug today?
I can only be one place at a time.
Indeed, indeed. And are you going to hug anyone today?
I'm going to hug my mother.
She just had a birthday, didn't she?
Yeah, it's another year starting. I'm grateful for her being alive and being with me. So I'm going to hug my mother.
Give her one for me too, brother.
Will do.
Good.
Definitely. I will tell her that's from you too.
Gio, I want to come to you, the author of this question. Brother, how are you?
Saurel, thank you for asking that. I am the way that I say that I am. And today I say I am goofy.
Is it just today, Gio?
Well, today I say that.
Okay, that.
Tomorrow I'll say something else.
I am goofy too. And, you know, in the context of completing the year and looking, not so much looking back at 2022, or either looking forward at 2023, there's this aspect of being complete in everything we have accomplished and everything we have hoped for that came about or did not, that resides right here in the now. So maybe looking back at 2022, or looking forward at 2023, though they contribute something to completing the year, maybe looking right here, right now, is where we are. So our question this morning, Gio, is what you can't put behind you runs your business. And the minute that question comes up, I imagine you and others are thinking, oh gosh, there's all the things that didn't work or didn't work as well as I'd like it to, that I must really work hard to put behind me so that 2022 could be better. That's not what this conversation is about. This conversation has a surprising twist. One of the things, many of the things that you're thinking, oh, I don't have to put that behind me, you might discover in this conversation that there is an opportunity to put that behind you as well. Now, before we reveal that, Giovanni, I'd love for you to take a moment now and create the context for this conversation.
Yes. Thank you, Saurel. Thank you. Yes. So, if you are someone who's up to something for 2023, yes, you have goals, or you're on your way at some point, either today, tomorrow, or at the first week of January, you're going to create some goals for yourself, right? I mean, raise your hand if you have goals for yourself for 2023. Yeah, most of us do. And particularly if you're not, this is not the beginning of being an entrepreneur for yourself, you definitely have goals. If maybe you're at the beginning of having a business or creating a new journey for yourself or making a transition from being an employee to becoming an entrepreneur, maybe the goals are not quite there yet as a must to do at the beginning of the year so that you can frame your brain, right? You can frame your brain to look for opportunities for the rest of the year. Maybe you're not there, but they're a must. But for the rest of us, it is a must. At some point, we get into a journal or we go somewhere and we start writing down, what would we like to create for 2023? And the juicier, the better, right? And maybe you do collaging and you put the things that, pictures of things that you want to see. I remember the first time I did a collage, my biggest dream was to have a computer. And I mean, when I put the computer on my collage, it was like, that is never going to happen. You know, like that was where I was in my life. And I was all like nervous about putting a computer because I didn't want to be disappointed. You know, and so sometimes we don't really put what we really want in that collage or because we don't think it's possible. But then with a little bit of help and with a little bit of a community like ours, you begin to set some real outstanding goals, right? And in that process,
Gio.
Go ahead, Saurel.
You know, you said something really important, and I want to just repeat it so that in the context of this conversation, people get our invitation. Our invitation to you this morning is to actually, whenever you do it, even if you're not doing it now, write down as a goal what you really want. Very few of us really answer that question. What do you really want? And Gio, that is essential to the process of really expanding and creating something.
Oh, absolutely, Saurel. Thank you for saying that, Saurel, because, you know, the person that was helping me do a collage, right? You know, someone a lot older than me with a lot of experience, like you said, but why do you want a computer? Like, why? And what I didn't want to say is that I wanted to go to school. That's what I didn't want to say. And then I said, because I want to go to school, but, you know, I'm an immigrant. I don't have ways to be here legally, you know. It was a stretch to go to school, like really, you know, here in this country at the time. And he said, no, that's the goal. So do a collage around that. Man, that was the biggest stretch of my life. At that time, going to school was the biggest stretch of my life. So whatever it is stretching you, either do a collage, write it down. Just allow your brain to start looking for opportunities consciously and unconsciously. Now, having said that, as you're growing in your personal growth and development or in your professional development, one of the things that become critical is to look for emotions that are you're holding on to from things that happened in the past. So you look for things to let go. Maybe something that you let go in 2022, you know, things that happened to you at 2022 that you didn't like. Maybe a bankruptcy, or maybe a divorce, or maybe you gained way more weight than you wanted to, or maybe, you discover you have diabetes, or some, you gotta let go things that happened in 2022 or before, and it's important to let them go. And yesterday with Dr. Ogando, we're looking at a really remarkable practice to do that. What am I relieving myself from? And you got to write it down. You got to connect with that emotion, write it down, and to the higher self, allow yourself to let it go. Allow yourself to forgive yourself, forgive someone, so that you can get to this place where you can create, right? Anything else you want to add, Saurel?
Yes, Jill. There's the opportunity to have a blank slate. And we want to make that literal. A literal blank slate, because as a human being, the way my brain works, Jill, it works like this. You know, if there's something I really didn't like in 2022, like this awful throat condition I developed, guess what? I'm going to create 2023 and have goals designed to avoid that. And then if there's something I really loved, like we ended up getting two major projects at the end of the year that really created something big for our company, I'm going to look for ways to repeat that. And what I'm doing without noticing it is that I'm giving what happened in the past the opportunity and the power to create what I want in the future. So that's not the blank slate. So there's the opportunity in this conversation for us to discover and for people to realize that what you're letting go isn't just the things you didn't want or the things you didn't like. Are you going to go there?
Yes. So if you could do it by steps,
yeah,
right? Like you're pointing to, it would say, we would point to, there is... It's critical to look, you know, where you have a moment with yourself and look. What do I want to let go, or what do I want to relieve? And you want to write it down that happened in 2022, an upset with someone, or a goal you didn't achieve, right, Saurel? Because we do have goals that we didn't achieve, and you could be feeling a little...
Disappointed
or resigned.
Yeah.
It's important to let those go. And the next steps, I think that you were pointing to that, Saurel, is to begin to look, well, what else could I let go? If it's maybe goals that I didn't achieve or emotions that happened during the year, what else could I let go? And we want to encourage you and invite you to let go also your biggest triumphs, the very things that you did achieve. You know, like during the year, you did achieve something magnificent. You did build a building, you did buy a house, you did get your gig, you did write your book, you did get a bestseller. Saurel and I this year, we got a bestseller. High five, Saurel.
High five, Saurel.
We got a bestseller. Whatever it is, your biggest goals, to also let them go. Because you see, one of the things that happens, that it's not so much in the front view of our consciousness, if you will, when we achieve something, is that we begin to become attached to them. Like they mean something really big. So if you achieve something that you are so proud of, you've been working on for a long time, you know, 5 years, whatever that is, then all of a sudden you, and you don't really notice this, or people, right? Certainly this has happened for me. I don't really notice this, but then I begin to become attached to my accomplishments. So now, like this year, our company started working with the United Nations. Very huge. That was one of the biggest accomplishments of my lifetime. However, if I make that an accomplishment, if I become significant about it, then I all.
Gio, pause for a second. I'd love for you to remove the word if, because as it happens in life, when I have a big accomplishment, it's not if I become attached to it. It is that I do become attached to it, and it begins to define for me and for the rest of the world who I am. It's like, hey, I have a bestseller, man. Come on. Who are you talking to?
Exactly. Like, thank you for saying that. It's not if. And this is this might be a stretch for some of you, but the moment Saurel said it, I saw it immediately for me. It's not if. The moment I achieve a goal that is worth something to me, I immediately, not that I intentionally do it, automatically, as the human being that I am, create an identity for that, an attachment in my identity. Like, you know, it was important. This is important. And what also happens automatically, not intentionally, there's a difference between doing something intentionally and something automatic, but they both happen anyway. What also happens is that I could start walking in life like I'm important. Now, nothing wrong with being important. It's very important. It's very cool to have self-value, right? However, the issue with that is that if I'm walking around important, then people around me are not important, you see. They're not that important. Or when you achieve a particular goal in your sales goals for your company or for whatever you do, like, oh, now you're a six-figure earner or a multiple six-figure earner, or a seven-figure earner. So now it's like, oh, so now I am, and you can't see it, but you become better than others. And now your triumphs become your ego trip. Now they become in the way of your being related to life. You can't relate anymore because now you have an ego created by your achievements. And it happens immediately. So what we are inviting you is to also let go of your triumphs. So in our company, every single week, on Monday, we create the context and the goals for what the week is going to go. And on Friday, we complete it. We complete our biggest triumphs, our biggest goals, and also our biggest disappointments.
So if you could imagine.
We complete. Go ahead, Saurel.
I was thinking, Gio, as you're saying that, if you could imagine having a big eraser, where once a week, and we're inviting you to do it now, where you take that big eraser and the figurative blank slate that we're talking about, you really truly do have the power to create it. You take every failure, every disappointment, every triumph, every big accomplishment, and you go, you literally erase them. And the opportunity is to either say them or write them down. This is what I accomplished. These were my disappointments. And whatever you do with it, you can flush it, burn it, but it's the practice of actually erasing the slate. Because whether you want it or not, it is in the nature of being a human being to be creating my future, tethered to what didn't work or what worked, tethered to what I liked or what I didn't like, tethered to what I wanted or what I didn't want. And this opportunity of completing the year using this magical eraser that we're giving you now is the opportunity to create that blank slate.
Now, one aspect that I want to share with you is that the moment you're going to let go of a big accomplishment, you know, like you go, you say to yourself, okay, one of the things I want to let go this year was, like, for me, would say, like, to work with the United Nations. I want to let that go. The moment you're saying that, unconsciously or consciously, you might think, if I let that go, then I can't create it again. No, it's not like that at all. It actually empowers you. You're actually free to create it again without the comparison of the past, without the must, without the should. I wanted to add that, Saurel.
And the other thing I wanted to add. And that's perfect, Gio, because guess what? This conversation isn't also to dismiss what we have achieved, what you have achieved. Because guess what? When you put that goal down and you say, in 2022, I want to achieve X, it is attached to how and who you want to become. And when you achieve that goal, when I achieve that goal, I automatically say, oh, man, I made it. I've gotten there. I am X. And that's how the attachment gets cemented. And the exercise of acknowledging that even that big accomplishment doesn't get to define next year. Even that big accomplishment doesn't get to define me. Even that big accomplishment doesn't get to define my interactions with you. That's where the power is.
Yeah, so we want to leave you with this opportunity to create a blank slate for yourself in 2023. Now, one last thing I want to say, and I'd love to invite you to put in the chat or raise your hand and share with us what is one big accomplishment you want to let go. And the opportunity of a blank slate is very powerful. When you get to nothing, when you get to nothing in yourself, there's nothing in front of you. It leaves you with power, but not more powerful than something else. Just powerful with nothing. And then you can start listening to the power that it is around all of us that helps the trees grow, that moves the tides. But it's not more powerful than something, it's just power itself. And we want to invite you to get there. So if you don't mind putting in the chat or maybe coming off of mute, raise your hand. What is a big accomplishment that you would like to let go this year? And if you also want to let go on disappointment, go ahead and share it without the story, obviously, of what happened. We don't have that much time. But mostly we want to hear for you to stretch yourself and let go a big accomplishment.
And if you've let it go and you actually have a huge declaration you want to make, you might do that too.
Yeah, not today.
Man,
otherwise, that would be the entire thing. Saurel, do you have an accomplishment? Go ahead, Laura.
I don't know if this is a big accomplishment, but for me, letting go of control. Letting go of control for me was a huge accomplishment.
Wow.
Yes.
You got that.
Thank you, Laura. Letting go of control. Wouldn't that be a big deal? Now, that would be an accomplishment for 2023, right, Laura?
Yeah.
And that will be, go ahead, Saurel. Go ahead.
I think Laura was saying that for her in 2022, she let go of control, and that was a big accomplishment.
Is that what it is, Laura? Or that's
that was a big accomplishment for me.
Oh, perfect, perfect. Yes. Perfect. Got it, Saurel. Thank you, Saurel. Anybody else? What's a big accomplishment that you like to let go?
Go ahead, Cece.
Hey everybody, this is Cece. I like this. I let go of my biggest accomplishment, which was I started a new career as comedy. So I'm now speaking in front of lots of people in comedy. I talk about my biggest failures. I talk about my biggest accomplishment, and it has produced freedom and has opened more opportunities that I could even ask or even think. So thank you guys for this platform, and I pass.
Oh, that is phenomenal. That's a big accomplishment to let go.
Ronald put in the chat, he wants to let go that he's designed a 10,000 square foot home.
Very good. Awesome. That isn't it liberating, Laura, Cece, Ronald? Like, as you're typing it, you're like, oh my gosh, I don't want to let this go. I mean, this is my accomplishment. And then I was just like, oh, I can do this again. Let's do it again. That's really great. Anybody else? Anything else that you want to let go? Or what's your experience of this conversation? What are you getting from this conversation? What are you discovering?
I'm thinking this conversation is very much tied up with, Monica's talk yesterday. I know you mentioned that earlier, but I think it's really tied up to it. And it's an exercise that definitely worth taking on, because yes, the accomplishment can freeze you. I'm getting that the accomplishment can freeze you and not really propel you to many more. I mean, and that's one thing I'm really putting on my goal this year. It's not a one-time wonder thing, you know? It's like, it's a continuous thing. It has to happen, you know? I see United Nations for you, and then I'm seeing, a world, another bigger world organization, you know, that like the Hispanic community for you. And it's done. It's an accomplishing task. It's going to happen for you in 2023. So the future is already there for you. So I'm looking at that for me that, I mean, it's amazing. I spoke to a client yesterday who's also already looking at another house, and I try not to take big thing. I mean, not take big thing, but multiple thing, but one thing that I can focus for and say, okay, this is going to be 2023. We're going to walk that we're going to probably a 15,000 square feet home, you know? So that's it, man. Great conversation. Thank you, guys.
Thank you, Ronald. Go ahead, Rashida.
Good morning. Good morning, family, Daily Huddle. I am so, I have accomplished so much this year. I started my first vacation rental this year, and I would say that I started in May, and it's generated a lot of income that I can start a second one next year, March. I'm starting my second vacation rental. But the more what I have, I wouldn't say achieved, but I went through some try a fate when my boyfriend went into coma for a whole month. Oh my God, isn't that where I started to find out how strong is my spirituality, my belief that there is a higher power somewhere, where I don't know, but that time at that 4 weeks of my boyfriend in coma, everybody giving them opinion and everybody saying everything, I have never lose my faith. Never. I believe that he was just on a journey. He was on a vacation and he was going to be back. Right now, he is home, what, 3 months after he's been in rehab for two months. So the journey being a long journey, but what a lesson it have left me to understand that we are just a vessel, and we just need to know that love is all about loving first yourself before you can love anybody else. So love is what I would really say that I have learned strongly this year, for just being in the belief that it was just on a break. And every time I tell people, he went on a break for 3 months, a month of a coma and 2 months of rehab. And everybody said, you take it as a joke. I said, no, that's what I learned from the journey that I was with him at the time. Trust me, that spirituality level and the belief and the love that you have for that individual, it makes a difference in each one of us life. And with that, I'm complete.
Thank you, Rashida. And, you know, the invitation is there. You know, I want to acknowledge everything that you've learned, the love that you've given, and the space that you have been for your partner such that he could take that long break and come back home. And then, and that's, you know, even that space, even that huge accomplishment is also something to just let go. So thank you for looking in that direction. Thank you to all of you. Giovanni, you know, this is the time where we get to say, Happy New Year. Or what year are you creating? And then people get to say, I'm creating the year I say I'm creating. Because this is the space where you are here now and the creator of everything in your life. Gio, what do you want to say to say Happy New Year, brother?
Thank you, Saurel. Goodness, how to encompass in a few words my profound love for each one of you. Thank you for being the part of the Daily Huddle family and coming here almost every day or whenever you come. Thank you for being part of our life and sharing your thoughts and sharing your life and sharing your accomplishments and sharing your, in many occasions, some of us share our breakdowns, right? And you do it so generously during the year. And I just want to thank you from the bottom of my heart for being part of my life, for being part of our life. Just thank you, really thank you. And I, like Saurel likes to always tells me, so what year are you going to create? Mm-hmm. You know, I don't want to wish you a great year. I want to have you create a great year, right? So happy new year. Hope you have a phenomenal time with family and friends. And if you don't, then come to my house. It's open.
And
that's what I wanted to say.
Thank you, Gio. You know, everything is always new, so long as it's coming through your lips. So you may, not may, you will, at the beginning of next year, hear us ask the question, what time is it? You will hear us ask the question, where are you? You will hear us ask the question, how are you? And though the answers will always be the same, know that every time you utter the answers and hear them, the time is now. I am here and I am the way I say I am, that you are creating and creating a blank slate and creating life in that moment. And so upon this blank slate, I invite you to love. Love abundantly. I invite you to stress less. I invite you to eat mostly plant-based. It's amazing what you'll discover when you start doing that. I invite you to sleep, give, and laugh out loud. Shake what your mama gave you and lest you wreck yourself, check yourself. This is our daily huddle, our last occasion for the year, and our first occasion will be this coming Monday. We'll be seeing you there and here. Until then.
Ashe, thank you.
Guys. Happy New Year.
Happy
love
New
you all.
Year, guys.
Happy New Year. Year.
Happy New Year.
Beautiful,
year.
Beautiful.
Bye. Thanks, blessings.
Thanks for keeping the light
feliz
on, guys.
Año, feliz año.
Feliz año. Feliz año.